FS1 to Seaview. FS1 to Seaview, come in, please.
Go ahead, Lee.
Do you have a fix on us, Admiral?
I have you directly over the target, just inland from the coast.
There's something, something very wrong, Admiral.
Wrong how?
Well, there's nothing but 500 square miles of jungle below us.
Just a second. At that point on the Italian coast, you should see below you the town of Pondicori. Lucia, 10 miles inland. Melito, 20 miles inland.
I know, I saw the aerial photos. But the towns are gone, they've disappeared. It looks like the jungle swallowed them. Population, buildings, everything.
The reports are true. Better get back in.
Aye, sir.
-140 degrees, sir. Every compartment reads the same, rising steadily.
There's nothing wrong with the temperature control panel. Damage control reports our circuits normal.
The reactor could be overcharged. You know, who's on duty in the reactor room?
A new man we took him on this trip. Keeler, technician.
Does he know his job?
Yes, sir. I checked him out myself.
You better check him out again.
Yes, sir.
Flying 7 approaching Seaview, sir.
Prepare to give him a hand.
Get a chair.
Yeah, this way. Force the blood back into his head.
Phil. Control to reactor room. Control to reactor room.
Reactor room, Keeler.
Keeler, you didn't have any trouble down there.
We did have a slight malfunction, sir, but I corrected it. The heat should start dropping.
Good. In any case, the chief is on his way down to check your operation.
Aye, sir.
Okay, down here, Keeler.
Just reported to the Admiral, sir. There was a slight malfunction, but I corrected it.
Yeah, the temperature's dropping, all right. Look, after this, let's try to find the trouble before it happens. Hey, Keeler?
I'll do my best, Chief. Chief, you don't have any idea what kind of trouble is about to begin.
Voyage to the bottom of the sea.
temperature's a little high, isn't it, Chip?
It's almost back to normal now, sir. Slight malfunction in the reactor controls. Already corrected.
Very well.
Lee. Here's the area you were over when you called in.
Well, it's roughly triangular like this.
Evidently, the jungle growth starts in the sea here at the apex and then spreads out over the land.
And it's moving across it so quickly that all of Italy will be covered within a year. That makes sense. Italy's not even tropical.
Well, maybe not. But the growth is there and it's spreading. We've been asked by the Italian government to stop it.
If we can.
We'll start defoliation immediately.
Oh, you're going to use a laser beam to cut through the roots, right?
No. We didn't want to start the growth. A laser might accelerate it.
Well, then what's your answer?
Gamma rays. We'll shrivel it, leaf and stalk. I'll be in the lab working on a projector.
Jeb, lay a course for these coordinates.
The jungle has already taken over the land here. We will also start the jungle growth here, here, and here. The Sea View is the only submarine that can go to all these places without once touching land, which is why she'll be so useful to us.
But we cannot live very long in the cold, dry atmosphere of this ship.
We won't have to. We'll change the temperature and air composition suitable for us. Within 2 hours, we'll accomplish our purpose here. Within a year, my friends, Earth will be as it was 30 million years ago. Then everyone from our planet will travel across space and come here to live. Now, we'll start getting the Sea View ready to receive them.
And speed. We should be at the spot where the jungle growth started in about an hour.
How's the Admiral doing with his defoliation ray?
Oh, he's in the lab working on it. Notify us both when we get there.
Right.
Get rid of them. Now we'll change the atmosphere inside the submarine to the same kind we have on our planet. I will reduce the oxygen in the air and increase the carbon dioxide. The two of you will change the other gases to the same quantities we're accustomed to. Thank you.
We will be able to live now. But what of the humans aboard?
A lack of oxygen will prevent their minds from realizing what is happening. And if they die, it does not matter. My only concern is to make sure that Earth is made livable for all of us.
John, come in.
How's it coming?
I was just about to run a test. Excuse me. Let's go behind the shield, huh?
Works fine.
Not really. Part of the jungle, but it's not strong enough to destroy the roots.
Can it be increased?
It has to be. What's our ETA?
About 50 minutes from now.
Excuse me. Well, I'll try increasing the gamma radiation, cut down on the X-rays. It might be ready by then.
Can I help?
No. Just let me know when we approach the target.
Will do. Is it stuffy in here?
I hadn't noticed.
Just my imagination, I guess.
Chief. Pot of coffee. Either I'm going to sleep or I'm coming down with something.
Strongest of them should be gone by now.
See if it's time to move.
That's the control. Control room. Control room. Control room, do you read me? Come in.
Come in.
Morton here.
Now listen to me. Shut all air intakes. Go on emergency oxygen.
What?
Something wrong with the air support system. Now shut the intakes. Sound a general alarm. You got that?
Aye, sir.
Get out of there now.
Chief, wake up. Wake up, Chief. Emergency air. Get emergency air. Move. I'll alert the rest of the ship. You find Kowalski and check the air support system.
Yes, sir.
To all hands. To all hands. Go on emergency oxygen. Repeat. Go on emergency oxygen. All crew chiefs, check your personnel. Emergency oxygen. Emergency oxygen. Emergency oxygen. All hands on emergency oxygen.
Lee. Wake up. Wake up. And breathe.
Breathe, buddy. Breathe. Bessie's out. Help the others.
All crew chiefs, report the condition of your personnel. Report the condition of your personnel.
They'll be coming in here now. Normalize the controls, but there's more than one way to capture this submarine. Quick, find the other two. Bring them to my station in the reactor room before they're discovered. I'll be there.
Come in.
Go ahead, Chip.
I've sent Sharkey and Kowalski to check out the air support system.
Good. Are the men all right topside?
All secure, but we're coming up fast on our target. Half a mile from the coast and approaching the start of the continental growth.
I'll be right there. Any orders?
Just bring us into position. I'll have the gamma ray projector ready.
air mixture is normal. Well, the settings are okay. What do you make of it?
I'm second guessing nothing, buddy. All I know is everything is A-okay right now.
Air support to control room.
Go ahead, Chief.
Air support is completely operational, sir. Everything normal.
Roger. I better check the reactor again. Temperature registers 10 degrees too high.
Aye, sir. Hey, let's lose the ski.
Gladly.
All hands. Air support system reactivated. All hands return to normal air support.
Did you see what I saw?
Yeah. Look like, jungle fighters?
The silver faces?
Nah, come on. Let's go down the reactor room.
We've been seen.
Says the temperature is rising again.
I know. Must be a defective thermal control.
Keela, did anybody come in here?
When?
Just now.
Not a soul.
You sure?
You know it, Chief. There's nobody in here but us. And I've been here since my watch began.
Chief Sharkey to control room.
Go ahead, Chief.
Reactor normal temperature dropping. Keeler says it's a defective thermal control.
Very well. Have him install a replacement and return to station.
Aye, sir. Sir, there's just one more thing. Kowalski and me, well, we think we saw something in Corridor 7.
Well, what kind of thing did you see?
Yeah, well, jungle fighters.
Jungle fighters?
Yes, well, at least they were dressed in camouflage jumpsuits like paratroopers. I guess maybe you ordered up a special detail to land on the jungle out there, huh? I mean, that must be it, huh, Skipper?
Chief, I haven't ordered any special detail.
You haven't?
Chief, look, are you sure you saw these men?
Yes, sir. I think they had silver faces.
Silver faces. Chief, now listen to me, will you?
Yes, sir.
When the air support failed, you and Kowalski may have been hit by carbon dioxide narcosis. Hallucinations. Understand?
Yes, sir.
All right, now get Keela working on that thermo control and then report to sick bay for a checkup.
Aye, sir.
No kidding, Chief. Did you really think he saw something weird like that?
Never mind the cracks, Keela. You heard the skipper. Now replace that thermal control unit now. Come on, Ski.
Man, what a trip the two of you must have been on.
Hey, come on, Chief.
Begun. Within the hour, the sea view will be ours.
Obstruction dead ahead, sir.
Getting a soft sonar bounce, it could be a thick underwater plant growth.
You must be at the jungle seed bed. Let's take a look.
All stop. All stop.
All stop, aye.
Admiral, is your gamma ray projector operational?
We're in position.
I'll be right there.
Being dragged across the hall. Must be closing in all around us.
Better try a slow stern.
Slow stern.
All the stern slow, aye, sir.
All stop by. It's dragging us down.
Pipes are clogged. The controls do not answer.
Where's that coming from?
I don't know, but if we don't stop it, it'll take over the whole submarine.
Sir, the aft quarter is full of this stuff too. It seems to be everywhere.
Pipe, duct, and conduit. If we don't break loose, we'll be crushed like an eggshell.
Can't we use the gamma rays from the inside?
That'd be too dangerous. I'll have to try to cut us loose from the outside.
Chip, tell a diving crew to stand by.
Diving crew, stand by.
It'll take too long to get through to the escape hatch. I'll go out through the flying cell. Patterson?
Yes, sir.
Give me a hand.
Activity in this room.
Must have something to do with all this foliage. Chief. Chief.
Sir?
Break out guns and radiation counters. Let's see if we can find out where this radiation's coming from.
Aye, sir.
Chip? Check the rest of the ship, will you?
Right. This is the exec. I want all compartments to report their status at once. Repeat. All compartments, report your status at once.
It won't budge, sir.
Lines must be cut around the cleats on the outside.
Then we'll never get out.
I'll pry it open.
Here. no good, sir. We're not getting anywhere.
Now keep at it, Patterson. I think it's beginning to give.
This is no good, sir. Better get out while you can.
I'll try to burn through it with a laser gun.
An air pipe broke.
Our deck, we're losing our air.
What happened?
Radiation feedback from the vine. The air's getting thin.
Get out, sir! Get out!
Control to air support. Anybody there? Air support room. Control to engineering. Can't anybody hear me? Isn't there anyone else left alive aboard this ship?
Personnel aboard should be immobilized by it shortly.
Which ones do we want?
The officers and some technicians. We'll hold them hostage to ensure obedience from the crew.
Control to missile room. Missile room, anybody there?
Aye, sir. Keeler in missile room, sir.
You're the first one I've been able to raise. How many men with you?
None, sir. I'm all alone. I can't understand it, sir. The whole sub is filled with jungle.
We know that. Are you blocked in?
No, sir.
Then go midships. The captain, the chief, and Kowalski are on a search mission. Give them a hand.
Aye, sir. Get those three men. And Nelson. And if you can't get them alive, kill them.
Seems to be getting worse.
Where it came from, sir?
No.
Might be those jungle fighters we saw.
Yeah. Try to move up and take a look. Keep me covered.
Ready?
Did you see who it was? One of your silver-faced jungle fighters.
At least it's a relief to know they're for real.
Not too much of a relief. We still gotta get rid of this jungle growth or it's the end of Seaview. We can't stay here like this. Cover me while I get back to Corridor 3.
Oh, you're gonna run around behind them, is that it, sir?
It's worth a try.
Good luck, sir.
Now!
You think you can make it?
You can bet on it, Ski. Give them 5 minutes and an open fire from the rear, and we'll rush them. And our troubles will be all right there.
Uh-huh. Just like that.
That's right, pal. Just like that.
Oh, boy, that sounds great. That is, if we have 5 minutes left.
We haven't been able to contact any of the other crewmen. The jungle growth must have destroyed all the communication systems.
Well, no word from Lee?
Nothing. I sent Keeler to look for him, the chief, and Kowalski. So far, there's been no...
How's it look?
There's more hull damage in section D-17-19. Some flooding in compartment 111.
Well, it can't last much longer at this rate. Can't use lasers. The gamma ray projector's damaged.
Before long, the sea will crack open and flood.
You men arm yourselves. Take grenades. Follow me.
Doesn't sound good. Do you have a plan, sir?
Yep. Gotta find out what caused this, destroy it, get us out of here.
What are you doing here?
Mr. Morton told me to look for you, sir. What's with all this jungle, sir?
I'll explain later. Look, I might need you. Well, come along with me.
Aye, aye, sir.
Keeler, have you been exposed to radiation?
I was on duty in the reactor room.
That wouldn't do it. The reactor's completely shielded.
I have a little box, Captain. Just fine for holding little men. Inasmuch as I need your help to run this submarine, I'm gonna put you in it for safekeeping.
Keeler's behind all of this.
See anything?
Nothing.
They should have been somewhere from the skipper by now.
Something must have happened to him.
So what do we do?
We're gonna move out, that's what. We're gonna take those tumble ones out there and find out what happened to the skipper.
I'm with you, let's go.
I'll move around and see what's up.
Closer to finding Keeler and the others than we were before. You know, we've got to think about this situation logically.
Logically? There hasn't been any logic to any of this.
Yeah, but there has been. The jungle growth started on the Italian peninsula. Then here aboard Seaview, we've had humid temperatures, increased carbon dioxide, and more jungle growth.
So we're obviously dealing with some kind of interplanetary plant life.
I just answer one question, Lee. Why Seaview? What do they want with their submarine?
As a means of transportation, so they could spread their seed beds around the world.
Of course, but they don't have to sail to other parts of the world to do that.
Missiles?
Exactly. If they load the missiles with their parasitic growth, they can infest every continent, every country within hours. But we better be right. There won't be time for a second guess. Let's get to the missile room.
You humans are preferring death to a little cooperation.
Yeah, well, I don't know what you are, Keeler, outside of being an alien fink. But you got us all wrong if you think we're going to help you spread this jungle junk all over the world.
And it's fortunate for me that I've been able to determine how to do it.
You can't aim and fire those missiles. Fire them?
Yes.
Aim them accurately? Perhaps not. But I don't have to. Because wherever they land, they'll spread seed beds. And soon your entire world will be exactly like this.
There are plenty of smart guys on Earth who can figure out a way to get rid of it.
Perhaps. But how many will still be alive in a pure carbon dioxide atmosphere? Load the missiles up with our pure seed bed specimens. Short.
We can't help them now. They're ambushed near the missile room corridor. That means our guess about the missiles was right.
Don't get your hopes up. It's too late for any help now. Finish loading and prepare to fire.
Let's give it a try. One of us might be able to make it. Cover me. Those men were carrying grenades. Get them.
Start the missile countdown. Get ready to fire. Quick.
Mm-hmm.
Don't try to come in here, Admiral, or you'll die sooner than need be.
We're going to stop you, Keeler.
It's too late. We're returning Earth to its primeval form. Our people are going to inhabit it. Nothing can stop it. Not you nor anybody else on Earth.
The missiles are loaded with our seedbed vegetation. We have only to fire them.
Good. Start a 15-second countdown.
At once.
Admiral, they're gonna fire the missiles loaded with their seedbeds. On a 15-second countdown, you've got
15 seconds.
Rush them undercover through grenades. I'll cover you. You'll have 5 seconds to get to the fire control panel and reverse the controls.
Backfire.
Missiles are still in the silo. Yeah.
There's something else seems to be missing.
The aliens are gone.
No. Not quietly. Now let's get Sharkey and Kowalski out of bondage, huh? Cleared the jungle out of Seaview. This adaptation had better work on the exterior. As well as the foliage. Mainland should be cleared of jungle in just a few hours. Chip, you take her up.
Aye, sir. Blow main ballast. All ahead, 1/3.
Aye, sir.
Admiral. Oh, what about Keeler? How do you explain him?
Well, they put all of their seedbed growth into the missiles. And yet when we looked in his little box, there were bits and pieces of dead vegetation.
Keeler.
Keeler.
You find Kowalski and check the air support system.
Aye, sir.
To all hands. To all hands. Go on emergency oxygen. Repeat. Go on emergency oxygen. All crew chiefs, check your personnel. Emergency oxygen.
All hands on emergency oxygen. Emergency oxygen. All hands on emergency oxygen.
Lee, wake up. Wake up. I'm breathing.
Breathe, buddy. Breathe!
Bessie's out. Help the others. Give him a hand. Well, everybody out. By heaven, your feet!
All crew chiefs. All crew chiefs, report the condition of your personnel. Report the condition of your personnel.
They'll be coming in here now. Normalize the controls, but there's more than one way to capture this submarine.
Quick, find the other two. Bring them to my station in the reactor room before they're discovered. I'll be there.
Come in.
Go ahead, Chip.
I've sent Sharkey and Kowalski to check out the air support system.
Good. Are the men all right topside?
All secure, but we're coming up fast on our target. Half a mile from the coast and approaching the start of the continental growth.
I'll be right there. Any orders?
Just bring us into position. I'll have the gamma ray projector ready.
Air mixture's normal.
Well, the settings are okay. What do you make of it?
I'm second guessing nothing, buddy. All I know is everything is A-okay right now.
Air support to control room.
Go ahead, Chief.
Air support is completely operational, sir. Everything normal.
Roger. I better check the reactor again. Temperature registers 10 degrees too high.
Aye, sir.
Hey, let's lose the ski.
Glenn.
All hands. Air support system reactivated. All hands return to normal air support.
Did you see what I saw?
Yeah. Look like, jungle fighters? The silver faces?
Nah, come on. Let's go down the reactor room.
We've been seen.
Says the temperature is rising again.
I know. Must be a defective thermal control.
Keeler, did anybody come in here?
When?
Just now.
Not a soul.
You sure?
You know it, Chief. There's nobody in here but us. And I've been here since my watch began.
Oh.
Chief Sharkey to control room.
Go ahead, Chief.
Reactor normal temperature dropping. Keeler says it's a defective thermal control.
Very well. Have him install a replacement and return to station.
Aye, sir. Sir, there's just one more thing. Kowalski and me, well, we think we saw something in Corridor 7.
Well, what kind of thing did you see?
Jungle fighters.
Jungle fighters?
Yes, well, at least they were dressed in camouflage jumpsuits like paratroopers. I guess maybe you ordered up a special detail to land on the jungle out there, huh? I mean, that must be it, huh, Skipper?
Chief, I haven't ordered any special detail.
You haven't?
Chief, look, are you sure you saw these men?
Yes, sir. I think they had silver faces.
Silver faces. Chief, now listen to me, will you?
Yes, sir.
When the air support failed, you and Kowalski may have been hit by carbon dioxide narcosis. Hallucinations. Understand?
Yes, sir.
All right, now get Kilo working on that thermo control and then report to sick bay for a checkup.
Aye, sir.
No kidding, Chief. Did you really think he saw something weird like that?
Never mind the cracks, Kilo. You heard the skipper. Now replace that thermo control unit now. Come on, Ski.
Man, what a trip the two of you must have been on.
Hey, come on, Chief.
Our main push has now begun. Within the hour, the sea view will be ours.
Getting a soft sonar bounce, it could be a thick underwater plant growth.
You must be at the jungle seed bed. Let's take a look. All stop.
All stop.
All stop, aye.
Admiral, is your gamma ray projector operational?
We're in position.
We're right there.
Dragged across the hull. Must be closing in all around us.
Better try a slow stern.
Slow stern.
All astern slow, aye, sir.
Stop.
I'll stop by.
It's dragging us down.
Pipes are clogged. The controls do not answer.
Where's that coming from?
I don't know, but if we don't stop it, it'll take over the whole submarine.
clamp broke. Too tough to cut.
Sir, the aft corridor is full of this stuff, too. It seems to be everywhere.
It's in every panel, pipe, duct, and conduit. If we don't break loose, it'll be crushed like an eggshell.
Can't we use the gamma rays from the inside?
That'd be too dangerous. I'll have to try to cut us loose from the outside.
Chip, tell the diving crew to stand by.
Diving crew, stand by.
It'll take too long to get through to the escape hatch. I'll go out through the flying cell. Patterson.
Yes, sir.
Can you give me a hand?
Activity in this room.
Must have something to do with all this foliage. Chief! Chief!
Sir?
Break out guns and radiation counters. Let's see if we can find out where this radiation's coming from.
Aye, sir.
Chip? Check the rest of the ship, will you?
Right.
This is the exec. I want all compartments to report their status at once. Repeat. All compartments, report your status at once.
It won't budge, sir.
Vines must be caught around the cleats on the outside.
Then we'll never get out.
We'll pry it open.
Here. No good, sir. We're not getting anywhere.
Now keep at it, Patterson. I think it's beginning to give.
It's no good, sir. Better get out while you can.
I'll try to burn through it with a laser gun.
An air pipe broke.
Dead, we're losing our air.
What happened?
Radiation feedback from the vine. The air's getting thin.
Get out, sir! Get out!
Control to air support. Anybody there? Air support room. Control to engineering. Can't anybody hear me? Isn't there anyone else left alive aboard this ship?
Patterson.
make it. Air pressure against.
Oh, go on. Go on, I'll make it. Go on.
It's full grown in here. All personnel aboard should be immobilized by it shortly.
Which ones do we want?
The officers and some technicians. We'll hold them hostage to ensure obedience from the crew.
Control to missile room. Missile room, anybody there?
Aye, sir. Keeler in missile room, sir.
You're the first one I've been able to raise. How many men with you?
None, sir. I'm all alone. I can't understand it, sir. The whole sub is filled with jungle.
We know that. Are you blocked in?
Got it. Notify us both when we get there.
Right.
Get rid of them. Now we'll change the atmosphere inside the submarine to the same kind we have on our planet. I will reduce the oxygen in the air and increase the carbon dioxide. The two of you will change the other gases to the same quantities we're accustomed to.
Humans aboard.
The lack of oxygen will prevent their minds from realizing what is happening. And if they die, it does not matter. My only concern is to make sure that Earth is made livable for all of us.
John, come in.
How's it coming?
I was just about to run a test. Excuse me. Shield, huh?
Works fine.
Not really. Part of the jungle, but it's not strong enough to destroy the roots.
Can it be increased?
It has to be. What's our ETA?
About 50 minutes from now.
Excuse me. Well, I'll try increasing the gamma radiation, cut down on the x-rays. It might be ready by then.
Can I help?
No. Just let me know when we approach the target.
Will do.
Mm-hmm.
Is it stuffy in here?
I hadn't noticed.
Just my imagination, I guess.
Chief. Order up a pot of coffee. Either I'm going to sleep or I'm coming down with something.
Strongest of them should be gone by now.
See if it's time to move.
That's the control. Control room. Control room. Control room, do you read me? Come in. Come in.
Morton here.
Now listen to me. Shut all air intakes. Go on and emergency oxygen.
What?
Something wrong with the air support system. Shut the intakes. Sound a general alarm. You got that?
Aye, sir.
Get out of there now.
Chief, wake up. Wake up, Chief. Emergency air. Get emergency air. Move.
No, sir.
Then go midships. The captain, the chief, and Kowalski are on a search mission. Give them a hand.
Aye, sir. Get those three men. And Nelson. And if you can't get them alive, kill them.
See where it came from, sir?
No.
Might be those jungle fighters we saw.
Yeah. I'll try to move up and take a look. Keep you covered.
Ready? Did you see who it was?
One of your silver-faced jungle fighters.
At least it's a relief to know they're for real.
And not too much of a relief. We still gotta get rid of this jungle growth or it's the end of Seaview. We can't stay here like this. Cover me while I get back to Corridor 3.
Oh, you're gonna run in behind them, is that it, sir?
It's worth a try.
Good luck, sir.
You think you can make it?
You can bet, Oretsky. Give him 5 minutes and an open fire from the rear, and we'll rush him. And our troubles will be over right there.
Just like that.
That's right, pal. Just like that.
Oh, boy, that sounds great. That is if we have 5 minutes left.
Well, we haven't been able to contact any of the other crewmen. The jungle growth must have destroyed all the communication systems.
Well, no word from Lee?
Nothing. I sent Keeler to look for him, the chief, and Kowalski. So far, there's been no...
How's it look?
There's more hull damage in section D-17-19. Some flooding in compartment 111.
Well, it can't last much longer at this rate. Can't you use lasers? The gamma ray projector's damaged.
Before long, the sea will crack open and flood.
You men arm yourselves. Take grenades. Follow me.
Doesn't sound good. Do you have a plan, sir?
Yep. Gotta find out what caused this. Destroy it. Get us out of here.
Keeler. What are you doing here?
Mr. Morton told me to look for you, sir. What's with all this jungle, sir?
I'll explain later. Look, I might need you. Come along with me.
Aye, aye, sir.
Keeler, have you been exposed to radiation?
I was on duty in the reactor room.
That wouldn't do it. The reactor's completely shielded.
I have a little box, Captain. Just fine for holding little men. Inasmuch as I need your help,
to run this submarine. I'm gonna put you in it for safekeeping.
Keeler's behind all of this.
See anything?
Nothing.
They should have been somewhere from the skipper by now.
Something must have happened to him.
So what do we do?
We're gonna move out, that's what. We're gonna take those tumbleweeds out there and find out what happened to the skipper.
I'm with you, let's go.
To finding Keeler and the others than they were before. Now, we've got to think about this situation logically.
Logically? There hasn't been any logic to any of this.
Yeah, but there has been. The jungle growth started on the Italian peninsula. And here aboard Sea View, we've had humid temperatures, increased carbon dioxide, and more jungle growth.
So we're obviously dealing with some kind of interplanetary plant life.
I just answer one question, Lee. Why Sea View? What do they want with this submarine?
As a means of transportation, so they could spread their seed beds around the world.
Of course, but they don't have to sail to other parts of the world to do that.
Missiles.
Exactly. If they load the missiles with their parasitic growth, they can infest every continent, every country within hours. But we better be right. There won't be time for a second guess. Let's get to the missile room.
FS1 to Sea View. FS1 to Sea View. Come in, please.
Go ahead, Lee.
Do you have a fix on us, Admiral?
I'll have you directly over the target, just inland from the coast.
Now, there's something very wrong, Admiral.
Wrong how?
Well, there's nothing but 500 square miles of jungle below us.
A second. At that point on the Italian coast, you should see below you the town of Pondicori. Lucia, 10 miles inland. Melito, 20 miles inland.
I know, I saw the aerial photos. But the towns are gone, they've disappeared. It looks like the jungle swallowed them. Population, buildings, everything.
The reports are true. Yeah. Better get back in.
Aye, sir.
-140 degrees, sir. Every compartment reads the same, rising steadily.
There's nothing wrong with the temperature control panel. Damage control reports our circuits normal.
Well, the reactor could be overcharged. You know, who's on duty in the reactor room?
A new man we took him on this trip. Keeler, technician.
Does he know his job?
Yes, sir. I checked him out myself.
You better check him out again.
Yes, sir.
Flying 7 approaching Seaview, sir.
Prepare to give him a hand.
Get a chair.
This way. Force the blood back into his head.
Phil. Control to reactor room. Control to reactor room.
Reactor room, Keeler.
Keeler, you didn't have any trouble down there.
We did have a slight malfunction, sir, but I corrected it. The heat should start dropping.
Good. In any case, the chief is on his way down to check your operation.
Aye, sir.
You okay down here, Keeler?
Just reported to the Admiral, sir. There was a slight malfunction, but I corrected it.
Yeah, the temperature's dropping, all right. Look, after this, let's try to find the trouble before it happens. Keeler?
Do my best, Chief. Chief, you don't have any idea what kind of trouble is about to begin.
A little high, isn't it, Jim?
It's almost back to normal now, sir. Slight malfunction in the reactor controls. Already corrected.
Very well.
Lee. Here's the area you were over when you called in.
Well, it's roughly triangular like this.
Evidently, the jungle growth starts in the sea here at the apex and then spreads out over the land.
And it's moving across it so quickly that all of Italy will be covered within a year. Doesn't make sense. Italy's not even tropical.
Well, maybe not. But the growth is there and it's spreading. We've been asked by the Italian government to stop it.
If we can.
We'll start defoliation immediately.
Oh, you're going to use a laser beam to cut through the roots, right?
No. We didn't want started the growth. A laser might accelerate it.
Well, then what's your answer?
Gamma rays. We'll shrivel it, leaf and stalk. I'll be in the lab working on a projector.
Chip, lay a course for these coordinates.
The jungle has already taken over the land here. We will also start the jungle growth here, here, and here. The Sea View is the only submarine that can go to all these places without once touching land, which is why she'll be so useful to us.
But we cannot live very long in the cold, dry atmosphere of this ship.
We won't have to. We'll change the temperature and air composition suitable for us. Within 2 hours, we'll accomplish our purpose here. Within a year, my friends, Earth will be as it was 30 million years ago. Then everyone from our planet will travel across space and come here to live. Now, we'll start getting the Sea View ready to receive them.
And speed. We should be at the spot where the jungle growth started in about an hour.
How's the Admiral doing with his defoliation ray?
Oh, he's in the lab working.